generally the Tamil literature is having a five basic intervals. They are Sangam age, epic age, Bhakti literature, then Chitralakyam or Prabandhas, and modern literature. Likewise, we are having ethics literature also in that order. So the ethics literature are also having a long history in Tamil literature. First of all, we have to understand one thing. What we are saying ethics in Tamil, it is not law, it is not judiciary. We have to have it in mind very clearly. Law is different from ethics and justice is different from ethics. Law is meant for human being, ethics meant for being a human. So human being is different from being a human. That's why we are always insisting the ethics. In Tamil, ethics is called Aram. Justice is known as Neethi. So we are having two types of literature. One is ethics literature. Another set of literatures of literature on justice. For example, Chukra Neethi, Manu Neethi. These are all the books on justice. If a ruler wants to do something to the people or with the government, he has to follow certain rules and regulations and he has to maintain the law and justice. So that is totally different. But whereas ethics is totally different. Ethics is meant for every human being to act as being a human. That's the most important thing. So in Sangam age, we are having Pathu Paattu and Ettu Thogai. In those literatures, we are having now and then the ethics details. For example, in Purana Anuru, Seidhi Kondrorukku Uidhi Illana, the famous quote. If we are going to forget the gratitude, automatically there is no remedy for it. It is there in Purana Anuru. And some other ethics also mentioned not only in Purana Anuru, even in Agam literature. But whereas all these ethics collected in one form and people started to write a separate books on ethics, that is called Padinen Kizhkanakku. So the 10 long verses and 8 anthologies are known as Padinen Mel Kanakku. Another set of 18 books are known as Padinen Kizhkanakku. In that Kizhkanakku, we are having 18 books. In that 18 books, 11 books are on ethics. These 11 books are known as Sangam period ethics book. What are they? If you want to have the list of the book, I will give you the list of the book. One is Tirukural, second one is Naladiyar, third one is Naan Mani Kadigai, fourth one is Inna Narpadu, fifth Iniyavai Narpadu, sixth Tirikadugam, seventh Asarakovai, eighth Palamoli, ninth Sirupanchamoolam, tenth Yeladi, 11th Mudumoli Kanji. All these 11 books are coming under Sangam Age Ethics book. All these 11 books are coming under Sangam Age Ethics books. Likewise, in the medieval age also, we are having set of books on ethics. In the medieval age, we are also having a set. They are Arungala Cheppu, Araneri Charam, Narundohai, Neethi Neri Vilakkam, Nanneri, Ulaga Neethi, Mudu Moli Venba. These are all the books written on ethics in the medieval period. Especially in the medieval period, you have to give more importance to Avvayar. Because in the Sangam age, we are giving more and more importance to Thirukural. Likewise, in the medieval period, we are giving more importance to Avvayar Avayar's works are very important on ethics. They are Athichudi, Kondrai Vendan, Moodurai, and Nalvali. These are all the books written by Avayar, and they are all talking about the ethics. Then modern works in the later period, after the medieval, in the modern times, we are having few more books on ethics. They are Pudhiya Athichudi, Neri Sudi, Tamil Sudi, Neethi Sudi, Neethi Chintamani, Ponmadi Malai, Neethi Nool, Neethi Bedam, Vivega Chintamani. After that, yeah, another type of genre entered into the Tamil literature that is known as a Sadagam. Sadagam means 100 songs based on ethics. So those Sadagams are known as ethics books in Tamil in the modern period. They are Thandalayar Sadagam, Govinda Sadagam, Jayam Kondar Sadagam, Arappaliswar Sadagam, Kumaresa Sadagam, and Manavala Narayana Sadagam. All these literatures are in poetry form. The Sangam Age ethics book, medieval age ethics books, and modern age ethics books are all in poetry form. Later on, when after the invasion of Europeans, we came to know about the prose writing forms. So with the help of the prose writing style, we are having two ethics books. One is Aesop Kadegal, another one is Panjatantra stories, Panjatantra Kadegal. All these stories written in prose form. Through that stories, we are started to teach the ethics. So we are having a huge tradition, and we are having a very lengthy history on ethics side.
Sir, you mentioned Neethi is different from ethics. And yet when we were talking about the title of the books for modern, we were talking about Neethis. So
yeah, I will come to that side. Because even in Sangam age, we were having lot of different cultural people in Tamil Nadu. In the eastern side of Tamil Nadu, we were having the people from Burma, Cambodia, Thailand, Java, and Sumatra. All these lands are having traditional Tamil names. So we were having the people from eastern world. In the western side, we are having the people from Greek, Egypt, Alexandria, and Rome. So normally, there the people used to have some sort of trade with the Indian emperors, right? These people are having different law. In those days, in Sangam age also, the people and as well as the emperor were having the federal rule system. So the foreigners are having separate law, and the local people, the local Tamilians, are having a separate law. So that is the main reason. If you are not supposed to say the ethics is equal to law, law is totally different. Law is applicable only to the people, those who are belonging to a specific culture, if the law is not applicable for a different culture people. But whereas ethics is not like that. What the ethics we are having for our own people in Tamil Nadu or in India, the same ethics will be prevailing in any part of the world. That is the reason of the ethics. Ethics is universal. Law is having its own discrimination. So later on, what happened, in the Sangam age, we were having different people in the east and west. In the medieval also, we are having a lot of different religion people. Because Jainists were there, Buddhists were there, and all other foreign religions like Mughals and Christianity also having some sort of importance in Tamil Nadu. So every religion was having separate rules and regulation and law. So automatically we have to impose a different law for other religion and a different law for the local Hindu religion. That was the condition. Even today we are maintaining the same. It is a major issue for the government even today, right? In the modern period, automatically the entire India was ruled by the British people. So they wanted to impose certain laws, and as well as those laws are not equal to local law of the government. So automatically they wanted to write some separate books on ethics. In those days, ethics are not popularly accepted by the people in the modern period. So they started to write as Neethi Noolgal. So people are not knowing the difference between the ethics and as well as the law. In the modern period, especially in the British period and Mughals period, the ethics becoming law and law becoming ethics. That's why they were having the common name, Neethi Noolgal. But whereas in the Sangam age and as well as in the medieval period, we were having only the Aran Noolgal, the books on ethics. Very simple. What is the difference between the law and as well as the ethics means? In a war front, you can kill your enemy, that is law. Whoever the person, you are not supposed to harm them, that is ethics. Right. So, I am not going to harm any one of the people in the world, that is ethics. So, that may be changing whenever the rules and as well as whenever the emperors are changing. When Buddha was ruling, the people are following the Buddhism, automatically the law is accepting, don't harm anybody, that the general ethics becoming law. But when the government being ruled by the feudals, what happened? You have to kill your enemy, that is your basic duty. So that is the main reason, even in Tamil tradition, we are having a separate book on ethics and separate book on judiciary. So law can't be a ethics and ethic can't be a law. It is not at all possible. That's why even the first and the foremost work in Tamil, Thiruvalluvar's Thirukkural, he is having Arathuppal. It is completely ethics. But whereas in Porutpal, it is totally a chapters on the ruler. The Porutpal is the chapters on rulers. And Kamathuppal, it is meant for lovers. So the Arathuppal, it is exclusively for ethics. So in that Arathuppal, he is talking about Kollamai, don't harm anybody. But whereas in Porutpal, the king's main duty is to kill the thieves in the government. That is, so being a king, you have to adopt the law. But being an individual, you are not supposed to take the law in your hand and start to kill everyone. It is not possible. So that is the main reason, according to Tamil literature, the ethics is totally different from law. So you can't say both the things are same. It is not possible also. For example, why we are giving that much importance to ethics means, ethics will purify one's mind. If you are going to talk about the law, law is coming from your knowledge. Out of your knowledge only you are talking the law. But whereas the ethics is coming out of your conscience. So conscience is more powerful than your knowledge. It is more powerful than your experience. So conscience is more important than law. Concern to my mind, concern to my conscience, I'm not supposed to do any harm. That's the most important thing. But according to the circumstances, if I'm going to do some mistake, means I can easily get the, remedy through law, but not through conscience, through ethics. That's not possible. That's why Valluvar also says, if you are going to ask a question, what is Satyam? What is truth? What Valluvar says, truth is me. If you are going to talk harmlessly to others, that is called truth. And say, what is truth? As such, what you are going to see, if you are going to reveal the same, that is vaimai enappaduvathu yaadenin yaadondrum theemai illathu sola. If you are going to talk to others, don't talk anything, that is called vaimai, that is called the truth. That's why he is accepting, even if we are going to lie in order to save one's life, that lie also accepted as truth. Poimayum vaimayudathu puraithirnda nanmai payakkumenil. By way of saying one lie, if you are going to save a person or one person's life, it is allowed, you can easily say a lie. So what he says, so that is called ethics. If you are going to say he is lying, means automatically, if you are going to adopt the law for it, it is a punishable offense. But if you are going to adopt ethics for it, in order to save one's life, that person is lying, automatically he will be given excuse. This is the beauty of the ethics. So ethics need not bother about any legal administration. It is not at all bothering about any legal inputs. Concern to your mind, concern to your conscience, that one is right, means you have to. That's why Valluvar also says in his Thirukkural, Thannenji arivadu poyyakka. Concern to your conscience, if it is a lie, means don't say. Thannenji arivadu poyyakka. Concern to your conscience, it is a lie, means don't tell. If you are going to tell, your conscience will not allow you to live. Thannenjiye thannai chudum. That conscience itself will kill you automatically. So he is not at all bothering about the law. So in Tamil tradition, the ethics are totally different. Ethics are having its own importance. So the Sangam age ethics are 11 books. In that 11, Thirukkural is the most important one. Why it is most important one? All other literatures are having a poem of four. Yar, Palamoli, Innan Arpadi, Iniyavai Narpadi, whatever it is. Every book is having a poem. Every poem is consisting of four lines. But whereas Thirukkural, it is just a two-line poem. That two, the first line having four words and second line having three words. Within seven words, he was able to tell and teach the ethics to the world. That's the beauty of Thirukkural. So Thirukkural, it is totally 1,330 couplets. They are totally 1,330 couplets. And every chapter is having 10 couplets. So 133 chapters are there. And all the 133 chapters divided into three divisions. They are called Arathupal, Porutpal, and Kamathupal. What is Ara means? He is talking about the individual ethics. Individual ethics. How you are going to behave, how you are going to adopt yourself in a family, adopt in the society, what is the basic requirement of a human. Then how you are going to talk, and if you are going to talk with others, what are the words you have to use? All these things he is giving in the Arathupal. Porutpal is exclusively for rulers. Even a common man becoming a ruler or a regular king, what are the qualities of a ruler? What he has to do to the country and what he has to do to his fellow people and how he has to do the administration, what are the important things for a ruler, all these details he is giving in Porutpal. What is the quality of a king? How he is going to manage the time? How he is going to earn? What are his earning sources? What is his country? And what is his army? And what about his individuality of a king? All these things are rightly mentioned by Thiruvalluvar in Porutpal. Then if you are going to talk about a country, means what are the quality of a country? If you are going to talk about the army of a nation, what are the qualities of the army? How you are going to protect the army? If you want to run a government, to whom you have to get the advice, the ministers, the spies, and war generals, and the local great people, then how you are going to have your friends, the good friends, the bad friends, And these are all the people not to be a friend forever. All these things are he is giving in detailed form in Porutpal. So all these things are, if you are going to talk about Porutpal, Porutpal purely based on justice. It is not having any ethics. Porutpal, it is based on justice, because a king is supposed to maintain the justice than ethics. Right, that's the most important. If a king is going to find a thief in his kingdom, he is not supposed to have any ethics, and by way of having the ethics, giving huge sum of money to the thief and letting him free, not possible. If he is going to find the thief in his country, automatically king has to kill the thief, what Valluvar says, because you are not supposed to allow the weeds in the regular crops. The same simile he is using. கல்வாரை வேந்து ஒருத்தல் பைங்கூழ் களை கட்டதனோடு நீர். கல்வர் மீன்ஸ் தீஸ் தீஸ் ஒருத்தல் மீன்ஸ் கில்லிங் ஆர் பனிஷிங். இஃப் த கிங் இஸ் பனிஷிங் த தீஸ் தட் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு எ ஃபார்மர் இஸ் ரிமூவிங் த வீட்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் ஹிஸ் ஃபீல்ட். இஃப் இஸ் கோயிங் டு அலவ் த வீட்ஸ் இன் த ஃபீல்ட், தட் வீட்ஸ் வில் ஸ்பாயில் த கிராப்ஸ். லைக்வைஸ் the king is going to allow the thief in a country or in his ruling, automatically the country will get into chaos. So that is the main attitude of Thiruvalluvar. So in Porutpal, he is talking about the law. He is talking about the judiciary. He is talking about the rules and regulation of a country. But whereas in Arathupal, it is based on the ethics. What is the good quality of a man? If you are going to talk sweetly, iniyavai kural, you are not supposed to talk the harsh words, inna kuramai. You have to maintain the truth. Then you have to maintain the love and affection with everyone, anbudamai. All these things are the qualities of an individual. If you are going to lose your individuality, or if you are going to lose your ethics, you will not be allowed to, or you are not worthy to live in this world, he says in that chapter. But whereas in Porutpal, it is totally based on the skill and the rules and regulation of a king or a ruler. So after that chapter, he is talking about Olibiyal. Olibiyal means chapters on saints. What are the quality of a saint? Because a country is possessed with the regular citizen, rulers and warrior, and as well as the saints also. What are the qualities of a saint? He is saying very detailed manner. So he is not supposed to have the greedy. He has to think. He has to continue his penance forever. All these things he is giving in that chapter. That is called Olibiyal. And the third volume is known as Kamathup. That Kamathupal is exclusively talking about the romantic moments or romantic feeling between the hero and heroine. Even in that area is totally having some sort of difference. What are they? Sangamage literature is talking about the extramarital efforts of a hero. In Sangamage literature, you can see an extramarital affair of an hero. Even you can see the same thing in Silapadigaram also. But whereas in Kamathupal, Valluvar says the hero has to have only one hero. The extramarital affairs is not accepted by him. Thirukkural is not at all interested, is vehemently condemning the extramarital affairs. That's why in Porutpal, he is talking about Varaivil Magalir, Porutpendir. All these things he is saying, and they are the social evils. We are not supposed to entertain those type of people in the country, he says vehemently. One. And second thing, in Kamathupal, he is talking only about the ethical love. See the beauty, the ethical love. So he is insisting, if a person falls in love with the heroine or the girl, they have to marry as early as possible. The same thing is having the two division like Sangam age, Kalavu and Karpu, before marriage and family life. Both the things he is also insisting, but everything based on ethics. Everything based on ethics. So even the misunderstanding between the hero and the heroine, because of their proper misunderstanding, they are having the problem with them. It is not because of the third party's influence or third party's impact. The he is not accepting that. So everything based on ethics, that is the beauty of Thirukkural, and because of that only, everybody is accepting Thirukkural is the first and the foremost ethics literature in Tamil, right? Then after Thirukkural, any ethics literature having the influence and as well as impact of Thirukkural in their writing, especially the Naladiyar, Pazhamozhi, all these literatures are having the influence of Thirukkural. Because some of the literature book, how Valluvar classified his work, the same style of classification, these books also having. Right. Pazhamozhi, the Naladiyar, you can say both the Thirukkural and Naladiyar, both are having the same quality. The only difference is Thirukkural is 2 lines work, but whereas Naladiyar is 4 lines work. That's the only difference. Naladiyar is totally 400 songs. Thirukkural is 1,330 songs. That's all. The same type of classification Naladiyar also having, Aram, Porul and Kamam. The same importance. Then the beauty in that, I am interested in that both the Thirukkural and as well as Naladiyar are giving more and more importance to education. See the beauty in Sangam age, Purananuru says, even in a family, the king is accepting a person who is having well education. A saying by a poet, Orugudi piranda pallorullum, Muthon varigayanadu, avarullum katron mattu arasum sellum. What the poet says, in a family, there are 4 or 5 members, the king can hear only a word from the educated person, not from the elderly person. So in Sangam age, Purananuru is giving more and more importance to education. The same importance you can see in Thirukkural also. Valluvar says, if you are not going to educate yourself, you are an animal, he says. If you are a human means you have to educate yourself. If you are not getting the proper education, you are not a human, you are an animal. He says, Vilangodu makkal anayar, ilangunul katrarodu enayavar. If you are going to read a good book and develop your knowledge, then only you are known as a human. If you are not at all going to read anything, if you are not going to develop your knowledge and skill, you are an animal, he says. Even Valluvar is giving some other excuses also. If you are not able to read, if you are not able to go and study elsewhere, please hear what the scholars are saying. The next chapter is like that. Kelvi. Kelvi means you are hearing the scholars' language. If you are going to hear only the scholarly people's knowledge through your ears, Kelvi. So he is giving importance to Kalvi, Kallamai and Kelvi. And Valluvar is giving more importance to the friendship. Because if you want to assess yourself in a society, friends are most important people in everyone's life. So he says, Natpu araidal, kuda natpu, ti natpu, shittinam seramai. See the beauty? He is giving 5 different topics on friendship. Because they are the real people and they are the people with them only you are going to assess your life as a meaningful life in the society. So for that he is giving more importance to the friendship. So Valluvar, what he said in his work, that those things are likely to be elaborated in Naladiyar, that's all. For example, Valluvar says education is most important. Naladiyar also says, with the help of the education only, you can get the self-refinement. Immai payakkumal, iyakkurai vindral, thammai vilakkumal, தாம் உளரா கேடென்றால் எம்மை உலகத்து யாம் காணோம் கல்வி போல் மம்மரருக்கும் மருந்து. வாடிகி சேஸ் இம்மை பயக்குமால் நாலடியார் சேஸ் எஜுகேஷன் த்ரூ எஜுகேஷன் ஓன்லி யூ கேன் எக்ஸ்போஸ் யுவர் செல்ஃப் இன் திஸ் வேர்ல்டு ப்ராப்பர்லி. ஈய குறைவென்றால் whenever you are going to teach, whenever you are going to give education to others, it will not be reduced from your side. So it is going on increasing. Tammai vilakkumal, it gives the self-assessment. Through education only you can get the self-assessment. Thamulara kedindral, whatever the knowledge you are having, that will not going to harm you at all. It is going on giving the betterment in your life. Thamul. எம்மை உலகத்து யாம் காணோம். ஸோ ஐ எம் சேயிங் த எஜுகேஷன் இஸ் த பெஸ்ட் திங், இட் இஸ் த பெஸ்ட் மெடிசன் ஃபார் விச் ஒன் இஸ் கோயிங் டு ரிமூவ் ஆல் த சாரோஸ் ஆஃப் ஹியூமன். மம்மர் அறுக்கும் மருந்து, மம்மர் மீன்ஸ் டிசீஸ் ஆர் சாரோ. த்ரூ எஜுகேஷன் ஒன்லி த என்டையர் சாரோ ஆஃப் த மேன் கைண்ட் வில் பி டெஸ்ட்ராய்ட். ஸோ த சேம் திங் வள்ளுவர் ஆல்சோ சேயிங் இன் ஹிஸ் ஒர்க். ஸோ
What could be Valluvar's similar quote for this, sir?
Valluvar says, Kalvi is the wealth, he says. The education is the wealth to the mankind. If you are not going to have that education, you will not be considered as a human in this world. Okay. Right? So, the education is the wealth, he says. Right.
So,
you can...
sir, my question is, what time frame is
Naladiyar,
sir?
After Thirukkural. Naladiyar also after Sangam age.
Correct. So, when Valluvar has already written that, and Naladiyar believes in it and is inspired by it, apart from making these seven words into four lines, why another piece of work? I'm a little confused.
Not only another thing, Naladiyar is not only the book, other 11 books are there, not one. After Thirukkural, there are 10 books. In Padinan Kulkanaki, in that 18 books, we are having 11 ethics books. Because the periodically you wanted to reinforce the ethics that is most important in the society. Because law can be changed. According to the people, according to the environment, you can change the law. But you can't change the ethics. You have to reinforcing it periodically. That's the most important thing.
So what I'm understanding is, when someone as brilliant as Thiruvalluvar has already made a set of rules and it's extremely clear, even if we are not even a match to it, when it comes to us, when it comes to our turn, we yet have to re-establish and reinforce it in any way that we can. Even if it is not worthy, we yet have to reinforce it because that's important for the continuity of practice.
Exactly. That's the most important thing. One. Second thing, some of the ethics were mentioned by Valluvar, it is not possible for the people to understand immediately.
Okay.
There's another problem in Thirukkural. For example, I will give you one finest example. If you are going to commit a mistake, through that mistake, what the benefit you are going to get? There are two things. One is committing mistake. Second one is benefit out of it. So if you are going to get the real benefit out of it, you may argue committing mistake is not a wrong thing. Because of that mistake only, I gained this. So once Valluvar said, for example, if you are lying to a person, if you are going to lie, so according to Valluvar, what is the outcome? He is asking. What is the outcome? If you are going to lie, if you are going to get a good thing out of it, that good thing also not going to get any benefits for you. If it is a proper benefit for others, automatically Valluvar insisting in that way, if you are going to lie, because of that lie, if the society or other persons are getting benefit, I can accept that lie is a right one. If you are going to lie, out of that lie, if you are going to get some benefit, exclusively you alone get the benefit, it is wrong. So this ethics is not supposed to be understood in proper sense at all.
But what is good for society depends on my perception, no sir? And that might not be right. So where's the question of judgment here?
No, it's not. That's the thing. Ethics is nowhere related to judgment. That's why I already told you, judgment is different from ethics. For example, if a patient is admitted in the hospital, his condition is very serious. If you go and approach the doctor, he says, wait and see. But doctor, he himself knowing it, he is not going to mend that patient. That patient is going to die within a day or two. He knows very well. But what he says to his, or says to the people, those who are related to that patient, wait and see. We are doing our attempt. We are doing our, or we are giving our efforts. We will make it everything right. So the doctor knows it is a lie. Why he is saying that? Because of that, he can make some sort of psychological strength to the people. So this is not lie. Instead of this type of lie, if the doctor is going to develop his hospital and wants to feed his machines, for that he is going on saying like, you have to take this test and that test, then that time he is going to be a person who is lying, for that he will get the punishment.
I can understand it as if the intention is pure and exactly. Done with good intention, right, then it is justifiable.
Yeah. So that the thing may not be understood by the people in those days. So after Thirukkural, Naledyar wanted to give it clear-cut form. What Valluvar actually said in his work, this is the detail. So Valluvar has taken 7 words to explain his philosophy, but whereas Naledyar has taken 16 words to explain it, that same philosophy. Because people may not understand what it is. Because ethics are so difficult than law. You can easily understand the law book, but it is not possible. I will tell you another example. Valluvar says, Kodupadu Alukarupan Sutram. Udupadum Unbadum Inrikadum. What it means? Someone is having the charity every day, he is giving food to everyone. That is his basic duty. So if you are going there, get your day's food and eating, and you are eagerly coming out, because next day again you are going there to get your food. Instead of that, if you go and get your food and another quantity of food, if you are going to get, which one is going to be the another person? So Valluvar immediately says, someone is giving, if you are going to stop him not to give, you will be not getting the punishment. Your relation, your son and your wife will get the punishment first. It is pure ethics. Because what Valluvar says, because of that family member only, you are having that attitude. They, the people, indirectly inducing you not to allow that person to give others. Instead of that, you want to get everything for yourself. As long as you are an individual, you will be satisfied with that food. If you got married, you wanted to get more food for your family, for your wife, that more food is supposed to be given to someone, some extra person. So you are just cutting that. Automatically, Valluvar says, they are the people inducing to do the practice like this. That's why they will be the person get the punishment first.
So let me understand this. Supposing someone is giving food,
right?
I am going and taking food for myself initially.
Right.
And then now I get married and I have children. And so now I am going and taking food not just for myself, but also for my family and children. So I am taking food for 4 people. Because taking food for 3 extra people, I am stopping 3 others from getting food.
Exactly. Exactly.
And which means that my family is inducing me to take someone else's food.
Exactly, exactly.
And hence the punishment is for?
Them only first.
For the family.
then family first, then it will come to you. That's why he says, Kodupadu Alukarupam Sutram. Sutram means family. They will get the punishment first. Udupadum Unbadum Indrikadum. They may not have the dress to wear and they may not have the food to eat. They will be spoiling just in front of you. Because why the punishment is like that, you know? Automatically, Valluvar says, to whom you are doing the sin? Because of them only. So they have to destroy in front of you first. Automatically you have to realize, then only you will not be doing the mistake in your life forever. So that is the attitude of Valluvar. This type of punishment people are not knowing it. This type of ethics people are not aware of it. It is quite difficult.
They have to take responsibility of their action and the intention.
Exactly. So these are all the unique details and the unique way of punishing, unique way of giving punishment according to ethics. It's the Valluvar's doctrine and Valluvar's philosophy that may not properly understood by the people. Because of that only, the later on, the Naladiyar, Palamudi and so on, all the scholars started to write in elaborate manner. Though Palamudi is more important than or more or less equal to Naladiyar, that book is not getting getting the popularity because those proverbs, Palamudi means proverbs. Those proverbs are not commonly accepted by the people. Naladi are only written by many Jain saints.
Oh, okay.
Palamudi written by one scholar. His name is Moondurai Arayanar.
Okay.
So those proverbs are not commonly accepted nowadays. That's why that literature is not at all getting any proper popularity.
Okay.
So the fourth one is Iniyavai Narpadu means there are 40 poems. In that poem, the poet says, what are the good things to be adopted? Iniyavai means the good things. If we want to lead a comfortable life, what are the good things to be adopted? That is 40 things are there in the poem. It's a 40 poems. It is called Iniyavai Narpadu. Then Inna Narpadu means what are the things not to do? First Iniyavai Narpadu, what you have to do. Inna Narpadu means you are don'ts. What you are not supposed to do, that too also having 40 poems. That is Inna Narpadu. Then, Yeladi, Yela means cardamom. If you are having the cardamom in your hand, it will have a fragrance. Likewise, in that poems, what are the good things are mentioned by the poet? If you are going to adopt the good things in your life, you will get the beautiful or prosperous life in future. That is called Yeladi. Then another one is Thiri Kadugam. Kadugam means medicine. Thiri Kaduga means there are three types of medicines. If you are going to add that medicine forever, it will purify your body and it gives the cure your health also. So likewise, there are three principles or there are three points in every song. If you are going to adopt the points in your life, you will get a very good life in future. That is called Thiri Kadugam. And next one is Thiru Panchamulam. There are five types of medicines. Panjam means five. Panjam Moolam, they are the basic five medicine. If you are going to take that medicine regularly, it will cure all your disease. Likewise, every poem is consisting of five values. Five important values, every poem. So if you are going to adopt the values in your life, automatically you will get very good name in the society. Then
at a later date, can you give example for this?
From Naladiyar, from Palamudi, Yeladi, I will give one example. I will send it by recording. Right. So, and the Neeli Nool. Neeli Nool means what are the ethics to be adopted for an individual and for a ruler. That is called the Neeli Nool. So, these are all the books written in Sangam age by the scholars, and they are all known as Sangam Age Ethics Books. All these 11 books are coming under Sangam age ethics books. Then in medieval period, we are having some other ethics books. Because why we are classifying it? In Sangam age ethics books, the God has not given any importance. In Thirukkural, only one chapter is on Kadavul Vaazhthu. He says Kadavul means general worship of the God. He is not specifying any God at all. But whereas you can find the same details in Naladiyar and Pazhamoli. They are also saying only the Kadavul. Kadavul is more general term. There is no specific God's name or specific way of worship. You go and take Thirukkural, all the 10 Kural in Kadavul Vaazhthu, he is talking only about the glorious feet of the Lord only. He is not at all talking about the face, not at all talking about things about the God. He is talking only the feet of the God only. Because feet is quite common to everyone. Right. That's the most important. Piravi Perungadal Ninduvar Nindar, Iraivan Adi Seradar. கோழில் பொறியில் குணமேலவே என் குணத்தான் தாளை வணங்கார் தலை அறவாழி அந்தனன் தாழ் சேர்ந்தார்க்கு அல்லார். All these things he is talking only about the feet of the Lord. The same thing you can find in Naladiyar, in Pazhamoli and so on. But in the medieval period, especially during the Bhakti period, the poets decided to talk about the ethics along with the Bhakti. That's a major difference. In the medieval period, the scholars started to talk about the ethics along with the bhakti. That is the problem. So even now, why we are having that problem? For example, the Tamil Nadu government is having an endowment department. It is the department for Hindu temple only. But whereas for the churches and the mosque, they are having their own separate body and they are taking their rules and regulation. For that, the electricity is a common to everybody, right? But the government is charging 8 rupees per unit from Hindu temple and 2.5 rupees per unit from churches and mosques. See the beauty? See the beauty. So where is the ethics? The same thing happened in the medieval period. Because whoever the rulers, if the ruler is following one specific or one particular religion, if that religion is going to talk about ethics, that religion or that ethics book is favoring their own religion, their own people. So they were having two different type of ethics. One is the ethics for themselves and ethics for others. But whereas in Sangam age ethics, you are not supposed to find not even any difference for anything. You can't discriminate the ethics for the people. But whereas in the medieval period, all the ethics books based on the religion faith influenced the ethics and the ethics based on individuals. So if you are going to adopt Saivism, the ethics is different. If you are going to adopt Jainism, the ethics is different.
For example, please.
For
example.
No problem. Very simple. For example, in Saivism, if you are not supposed to eat non-vegetarian, because you are not supposed to kill any life. But whereas in Buddhism, it is easy for you, while you are wearing the saffron dress, you are not supposed to kill. If you are going to remove your saffron dress and kill the animal and eat and take a bath and come and wear the saffron, you will not be a sinful person. So, with the help of that particular uniform, you are not supposed to do. For example, I'll give one example from Periya Puranam. A king, his name was Meiporul Nayanar. He was an ardent devotee of Lord Shiva. So his enemy king name is Muttanadan. He wanted to have a warfare with Meiporul Nayanar. He attacked the Meiporul Nayanar's kingdom many times. Every time he only faced the loss. So it is not at all possible for him to win over that Meiporul Nayanar. So one day he decided, If I want to win Meiporul Nayana, the only way is I have to dress myself as a saint of Saivit. Then I will go and meet him. If I am going to have a if I am going to meet him in a personal manner, at the time I want to stab him. That was his plan. So he went there and dressed himself as a saint form, and he was having a small stiletto in the palm leaf scripts. And he approached the king, and the king was not knowing that is Muthanathan. He was thinking it's a saint. He is welcoming that saint, and this Muthanathan was saying, I am going to reveal sacred details about the Lord, so I need to have a private chamber. So immediately king brought that person into his personal room. There the escort is having a doubt on this fellow. That person's name is Tattan. So he is actually was saying to the king, I'm having the doubt on this fellow. No. He is coming in a saint form. I'm believing him. Please you keep away. So the Tattan was standing outside of the room, and the Meiporul Nayanar and as well as this Muthanathan were sitting, and Muthanathan was talking, I'm going to tell or reveal a very great thing to you. Before that, you have to do the namaskar. So the king was bowing his head. That's the right time. Immediately Muthanathan took the stiletto out of his hidden place and stabbed the king. Finished. So by way of having the stabbing, king shouted. Immediately the escort came in. The Meiporul Nayanar immediately told his escort, don't harm this fellow. Because though this fellow killed me or killing me, he is wearing the saint dress. So I am not going to punish this fellow while this fellow is having the same dress. Come on, take that fellow and leave that fellow out of our kingdom. Don't harm him. Don't harm him. That is the quality. So if a person going to wear or if he is going to wearing a saint dress, even if he is going to do a murder, he is excused. This is the Saiva principle. In
so those states. Not how it would be treated within the Tirukural law.
Yeah, right. Tirukural, it is a common law. It's a common ethics to everyone. But whereas in medieval period, if you are a Jain, if you are committing a mistake, the law is different. So yeah, it is not rational. It is totally partial. It is totally partial. So as a Jain, if you are not going to consume a liquor means automatically people will know in what circumstances that fellow is consuming a liquor. But whereas in Tirukural, in any circumstances consuming liquor is a sin. He says directly, don't drink the liquor. But whereas later on, in what circumstances, then only we came to know about the social drinking. If a king is drinking socially, it is not a big mistake. In order to pass the time, even for example, he says, in Tirukural says, if you are going to involve in gambling, it is a sin. Soothindra topic is there in Tirukural. But later on, if you are going to do the gamble for time pass, it is acceptable. See, this is the beauty. So periodically, the ethics are also changing. So Valluvar says, no, ethics are forever. They are permanent, they are eternal. You are not supposed to change the ethics. But later on, the religions taken importance than the ethics, and according to the religious faith, they started to teach the ethics. That was the problem in the medieval period. So next class, I will tell you what made the medieval period or medieval people change their ethics. Then we will come to modern, right? Thank you.